I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 2, lesson number 2. The topic it is forms of business unit. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudong. Welcome. Today still you are going to discuss about the sole proprietorship as a form of business unit. In our previous lesson, we said that a sole proprietorship, it is won by an individual, where we discussed about its ownership, its management, where they get the capital that we discussed in our previous lesson. But we didn't discuss about the merit of the sole proprietorship. Let us look at the merit of the sole proprietorship. This is the same as advantages of sole proprietorship. 1. We have few legal requirements to start the business, hence low cost of formation. Let's take these legal requirements. You only need to say permission. You request the local authority whether you can start the business. After they approve, you just get the trading license. Those are the only requirements before you start the business. Number 2, there is the quick decision making and implementation, since no consultation that is required. When you talk about the sole proprietorship, it is owned by only one person. He is the decision maker, he is the one to implement these decisions that he makes. So there is nothing like consultation. The only thing that is required, come up with that decision, then implement that decision. Number 3, the sole proprietor becomes one's business. Now, when we talk about the sole proprietor becoming a boss, it means that you decide on what to do, when to open up the business, or you are answerable to yourself. Number 4, cross contact between the business manager and his customers, and it's easy to handle complaints and cater for the customers' tastes. So due to that cross contact, you are dealing with customers directly. Remember, that is what we said. So you're able to meet the customers' complaints and customers' tastes. You're able to meet that. Number 5, a sole trader is able to assess the credit worthiness of the business. You are able to understand how much can I get as a loan in that is supposed to be solved, or that is supposed to be financed by my business. So you're the one who is going to look at the credit worthiness. Then secrets of the business are highly conserved. Since you're the only person who is dealing with the business, you does not give. Remember, there is no secret between two people. So in this case, it is only one person who is dealing with the business. You can keep the secret. Then number 7, the trader enjoys the profit. That means that you only enjoy the profit alone. You don't share the profit. Number 8, trader get assistance from their family members. This is the point where now you need the assistance. Maybe today I'm not, the trader is not there, he's not available. Someone else from their family, either a child or either the wife, you can be able to get assistance from them. Number 9, amount required to start the business is relatively small compared to the other business. As you can be able to see, those are the main merits. One-man control, less legal formalities. We also have unlimited liabilities, that is a disadvantage. We also have 1 month's capital, no sharing of profit and loss, then single ownership. That is about the sole proprietorship. Then we look at the demerits of sole proprietorship. He has unlimited liabilities. That means he is the only person who can get all the debts of the business. Number 2, expansion of the business may be limited by scarcity of resources. That means that you don't have the resources to expand. You don't have the capital to expand. You don't have that land to expand. And yet you are limited here, you cannot expand. Number three, long working hours and little time for recreation. So you need to wake up very early in the morning and also go to bed late hours. So there is nothing like recreation time. Number four, in the absence of sole trader, the business may lack adequate management. So a point where now you die, a point where now you just walk out of the business, we cannot get that adequate management that you are giving to the business from any other person. Poor decision making may affect the firm adversely due to lack of consultation. Remember, this one now will rely on one man's decision. So in case now you manage or you make decision poorly, then it means that the firm will get affected. Number six, lack of specialization in running the business may lead to poor performance. This is the point where now you run every activity, management, financing, you're the one who's doing the work, you're the cashier worker, all these ones now you are doing them in order for you to run the business. So you happen to have poor performance. Number seven, we have death of the owner may lead to the closure of the business. And number eight, sole trader may not benefit from economies of large scale. You cannot get a large and a substantial amount of loan discount. You just only get a small commission, the same, it is small. So you lack that enjoyment of large scale economies. Now, let us look at the ways or circumstances under which dissolution can take place. For us all, proprietorship. Dissolution means bringing a business to the end. It might be caused by owner's decision to terminate. When you decide today I'm not going on with the business, it is over. Number two, in case of the death, insanity or bankruptcy. This is the point where now someone dies, someone you're insane, and also becoming a bankrupt. Number three, completion of intended purpose. This is a point where now you intended to do this work and you have accomplished that work. So you just end up closing down the business. Number four, we have court order to dissolve the business. A point where now it is the court order that you're supposed to close the business. You can be able to see that person has woken up that day and decided to close their business. Just right, crossed. Assignment, describe the problem associated with a sole proprietorship form of business. Reference, KRB 2011, Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you have information that you need to get us, you can get us through the SMSing. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook and from the Twitter. Stay tuned to Erim TV.